Well, it's about a week later than normal, but the leaves are starting to return, and with that, the return of pollen season. In this week's episode of Heather's WeatherWise, I'm looking at the role that weather plays in our allergies. Over the past couple of years, images like this from the southeastern United States have been going viral. This one shows pollen piling up on the shoreline. Or how about this pollen explosion taken in New Jersey back in 2017? And this picture taken over North Carolina might look like an apocalypse for your sinuses, but all of that yellow pollen is actually pine pollen, which most people aren't allergic to because the spores are too big. Pine pollen gets a bad rap because that's what coats our cars this time of the year. But the real troublemakers pollinate at the same time with much smaller pollen particles. Around here, maple, elm, and juniper are what you should really be looking out for. And the leaves may just be opening now, but the pollen counts from them actually started to flower a couple of weeks ago. As we go through the coming weeks, different species of trees and plants are going to see spikes in their pollen counts as well. There are several resources out there that provide a pollen or allergy forecast, but how is that day-to-day forecast made? And how do experts know whether a season will be severe or not? Weather, of course, is a big answer. When it comes to making a pollen forecast, experts look at several different factors on a seasonal scale and a day-to-day scale. First, they'll look at the typical pollen count for a specific region and factor in the number of pollinating plant species. They'll also take a look at long-term weather trends. Did we have a wet fall? Has it been a warm spring? Both of those would factor into an above-average pollen season. Our fall season was fairly average with rainfall, and so far spring hasn't strayed that far from the norm, so no big concerns there. Now comes the day-to-day forecasting, and if you're an allergy sufferer, you've probably already picked up on some of these trends. Your symptoms tend to be worse if the weather is warm, dry, or windy. That allows those pollen spores to be aerosolized and transport very easily. On the flip side, damp, cool, and calm weather patterns tend to keep pollen levels under control, or at least the pollen isn't made airborne so easily. So at least that's one perk to how unsettled our weather has been over the past few weeks. That's gonna do it for this week's edition of Heather's WeatherWise. I'll see you next week with a new topic, but until then, remember, it's good to be a geek.